Student, so now we will start our next chapter, that is adolescence. That is your chapter number 10, and the topics which we are going to cover in this chapter are reproductive phase in humans, adolescent and puberty, changes during puberty, role of hormones during adolescence, secondary sexual character in male and female, sex determination in human, hormones and reproductive health. So, in our previous lesson, we have spoken about sexual reproduction in human beings. We saw how human beings give birth to new human beings. Okay. So, the only mode of reproduction that is possible in human being is sexual mode. Because we learn that there are two ways by which a living organism can reproduce. One is sexual and other one is asexual. So for sexual reproduction, you need two parents. Now in human being, you also need two organisms to reproduce, one male and one female. One father and one mother, they together give birth to a baby. In asexual reproduction, just one organism give birth to a new organism. Okay, it is not possible in case of human being. So we have learned a lot of things about asexual and sexual mode of reproduction in our previous lesson. So now in this lesson, we are going to talk about some more interesting things. We are going to focus on human beings, and we will see that when exactly we know that a human being is capable of reproduction. Is it like a human being can reproduce at any time? Can they reproduce throughout their life? Yes or no? So we are going to discuss about these questions. Now human life have different phases. So if you look at the life of any human being, whether male or female, life starts with when you are small baby, when a newborn baby, so tiny. Extremely tiny. Gradually you start growing and you reach an age when you are 3 to 5 years old. You play around, you go to school, and at the same time you all have a childish character. You again gradually grow and you become lady. Then you further grow and then you reach to 40s and 50s, and then finally you become old. So that's how the life goes on. Okay, so these are the various stages through which every human being can passes. Okay, so first three is are the infant, then three is the school going age, then we reaches an age where is neither a child nor an adult, something in between, and that is nothing but adolescence. Where you are neither a child nor nor an adult. So in this lesson we are going to focus on the adolescence, and then you will gradually become mature adult, and then this mature adult will further start aging and hair starts aging and you grow old. Okay. So these are the various stages, not only in the case of female, but in case of male as well. Okay. So they are also go through the same phase of a life. Correct. Now what we want to see in this lesson is there are so many different phases in which a human being passes through or comes across during its lifetime. So during which stage a man or a woman is capable of reproduction? In human being, we have seen that the reproduction takes place. How the reproduction takes place? When the sperm released by the men, they meet the fuse or fuse with the eggs which are released by the female. They fuse together and to form a zygote, and then the development of baby takes place inside the body of a woman for 9 months, and after which the baby is born. That is how the sexual reproduction is happen in case of human being. Now, is a woman capable of carrying a baby throughout his whole life? Not really. Do you think that a small child will be able to carry a baby in its womb? Not really. So there is a specific age group where the woman is capable of reproduction. Okay. Where similarly, there is a specific age group where the men can capable of producing sperms. So here in this lesson, we are going to focus on what is that phase when a person becomes capable of reproduction. So when and that age or that stage of life when a person becomes capable of reproduction, so that there starts adolescence. That means the person is gradually reaching or gradually becomes reaches to their adulthood. So the question is, when can an organism sexually reproduce? Okay. So when can an organism sexually reproduce? Now again, the entire life of human being can be divided into three phases, irrespective of whether the person is male or female. For all human beings, they have to pass through the three phases. So in the previous stages, we are talking about the different stages together depending upon the age. Here I am talking about the phases. So the phases is a more broader term than stages. Okay, you get to know about it. So the first phase is juvenile phase. That first phase is juvenile phase. It is that phase where maximum growth take place. Growth in the sense, size of a person increases, height increases, weight increases, and its fingers grows, each and every body part grows. So that's all, that's growth is take place a lot. Okay, but the person cannot reproduce sexually in this phase, and this is the first phase of a human being. So in this phase, the first in this phase falls the kids. They are called a juvenile phase. Okay, somebody who is just born, somebody who is 3 to 5 year old, or somebody who is maybe 7 or 8 year olds, they are all falls in a same category. This phase lasts approximately till the less till the person less than a 10 years. Okay, but again, it is not as necessary that this limit will be exactly the same for different for this all people, all this all the children's. Okay, that depends on person to person. Okay, but it is a first phase where the organism cannot be sexually reproduced. They cannot give birth to young ones. But during this period, there is a maximum growth. And that is why during this period, you can see a noticeable increase in growth of a person. Maximum growth, but sexually they can't reproduce. The next phase is reproductive phase. So this is the phase which comes immediately after juvenile phase. And in this phase, the person is capable of reproducing sexually. So this is a phase. Only during this phase, people are capable of giving birth to their new ones. Or within the phase also, there are many different stages. For example, the first stage would be the teenage, or we can commonly call teenage or adolescence, who are just trying to enter the adulthood. They are about to enter. They are not enter, they are about to enter. So these are the next category would be the those who are mature adults or young adults, you can say. They have already entered into their this phase. They are young adults. So these adolescents, they would be in the age less than 20. There would be somewhere around 11 to 19. Into which adolescents falling. Then young adults greater than 20, but less than 40. And when you, now the mature adults, they are like from 35 to 45, you can say. So all these people are capable of reproduction. They can capable of producing new babies. And then finally come सेनेसेंट फेस, एजिंग फेस, विच डिनोट द एंड ऑफ रिप्रोडक्टिव फेस. दैट पर्सन इज नो मोर कैपेबल ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन. सो इट इज इन सिंपल टर्म कॉल्ड एजिंग्स. ओके, सो वेन यू लुक एट द योर ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स और ग्रेट ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स, दे आर क्वाइट ओल्ड. दे आर मोर देन 50 ईयर्स और मोर देन 60 ईयर्स और 70 ईयर्स. दे आर फॉल इन अ सेनेसेंट फेस वेयर रिप्रोडक्शन इज नॉट पॉसिबल. ओके, दे आर नॉट कैपेबल ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन एंड दिस फेस इज ऑल्सो नोन एज एजिंग. सो दीज आर द थ्री मेन फेजेस ऑफ द लाइफ ऑफ द ह्यूमन बींग. ओके, नाउ द मोस्ट इंटरेस्टिंग एंड इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन इज वट इंडिकेट स्टार्ट ऑफ रिप्रोडक्टिव फेस. हाउ डू वी नो दैट द रिप्रोडक्टिव फेस इज गोइंग टू स्टार्ट. ओके, सो विच इंडिकेट वट इंडिकेट द स्टार्ट ऑफ रिप्रोडक्टिव फेज, अबाउट दिस विल गोना डिस्कस इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट. ओके, थैंक यू स्टूडेंट्स.